very exciting things that are happening, I think, in tab 32, because it's crucial that you can not only just retrieve or analyze your data, you can take your data to the whole new level. When you start achieving your full data potential, you start not just looking at historic data points, but you also start moving to more experimental and future-oriented applications. And this is what AI is, right? Mm-hmm. So machine learning algorithms are becoming very common, and this dentistry is actually not an exception. What you see now, examples of various carious assessment software tools being currently developed on the market, basically help provider to identify problem areas, mm-hmm. or at least take a look at the problem areas with the second, you know, for the second time to just, hey, pay attention, there's a problem here, maybe you didn't notice. Also, what we're trying to achieve is also a clinical decision support system. These are basically sort of a new developments that are computer-based programs. Those computer-based programs analyze the data within your electronic medical record. And it provides prompts and reminders in basically implementing evidence-based clinical guidelines at the point of care. Mm-hmm. So these tools will help dental directors at the DSO to implement and streamline clinical quality assurance across the multiple sites. And also, honestly, by making sure, it also helps individual providers to track and assess their own clinical outcomes, since most of us really do strive to provide better care.
Yeah. Absolutely. And I know that that's a big focus for us, I think, in the future as an organization and as a platform, is to help folks use their data more intelligently, right? And that's really what AI can do, is it can help, to your point, we can identify things proactively without a massive amount of effort by you and your team to say, hey, you really need to focus in this area. Something's changed. Something's going on. Now, whether that's, you know, like you said, carrier's identification or something on that side, or even just noticing a change in a patient's behavior or the clinic's behavior or certain key metrics, that sort of thing, and alerting you to those proactively. I think those are some of the benefits we can expect from AI in the near future.